Hello students, welcome back to our English class. Today we are going to continue our same chapter, Madam Rides the Bus from your first flight. So students, in our previous class, we learned how Wali was annoyed by the questioning made by or the inquiry made by an elderly lady who had boarded to the bus. Recently, the bus had stopped at a stoppage and some of the passengers had boarded into that bus, and an elderly lady, she also got into the bus and sat beside Wali. Wali didn't at all like the outer appearance of that lady. At the same time, that lady was making silly questions, silly talks, and that too was very annoying for that little girl, because she was enjoying the outside view from the bus and it was her first journey, it was her dream journey, and she didn't want any kind of interference or intervention from any stranger. But the moment that lady sat beside her, she started asking or throwing a number of questions from that little girl Wali. So she started with a question that if she was all alone traveling, so at this Wali, although she didn't like, but she replied that yes, she was all alone traveling and she was carrying a ticket of her own. Evidently, the conductor spared no chance to tease Wali again, and he had a good laugh and Wali to join the laugh. Fine. Now, that lady was continuously, or she continued to interrupt by asking abrupt questions out of concern. She was showing her concern towards Wali as she found that this little girl was all alone. So she was bothered about Wali's security, and that if she could reach, she asked her if she could reach her destination safely. She know about the streets, whether Wali know about the house number where she was going. So Wali assured her that she can travel all by herself. She doesn't need any assistance, and she just turned her face towards the window and started looking outside just to avoid further conversation with that lady. So till here we have done, and I had given you two questions from here. Fine students, and hope that you must have attempted those two questions of your homework. Keep sending me your homework through your Scholar ERP app. Now today we are going to start the third part of the chapter. Fine students, so here we go. Her first journey. Whose first journey we are talking about? Her is referred to as Wali's first journey. Okay, it was her first journey to the town from her village. So what careful, painstaking, elaborate plans she had to make for it. What careful, painstaking, elaborate plans. That means the plan was carefully made by Wali. Okay, it was painstaking. That means full of pain. How it was full of pain? Did Wali get any kind of injury while making the plan? No, she didn't get any injury. But painstaking means she had made a number of efforts. It was not easy for Wali to collect the informations. So all the informations she had gathered, whether it was regarding the ticket fare, the distance to be taken from her village to the town, or the amount to be paid for the fare or the ticket. So all these informations were gathered by Wali, and it took a long time. Okay, so it a collection of these informations over a period of time means painstaking and elaborate plan. So how her plan was elaborate? Children, she had not made that plan of traveling by a bus to the nearest town in a day. Okay, it was not a sudden plan of her that all of a sudden it came into her mind that today, yes, I will start, I will venture out from my home and I will go and visit a town. No, it was not a single day plan. It was, she had taken a number of days to plan it. So the plan was elaborate one, carefully made, and it was full of pain too. So Wali had taken pain in gathering all the informations, and you know that when without pain there is no gain. So Wali had taken the pain and she had gained what? She had gained all the informations related to the bus journey. She wanted to make that journey a successful one, a happier one, a pleasant one. So she had taken a lot of pain. She had to make for it. See, I read again. Her first journey, what careful, painstaking, elaborate plans she had had to make for it. One had is your helping verb. Another had is your main verb. So she had taken a number of pains, a number of efforts, and she had made a careful and an elaborate plans for her first journey. She had thriftily, so what she had done? She had thriftily saved whatever stray coins came in her way. See, stray coins. Stray coins means loose money. 25 paise, 50 paise, 10 paise. In earlier times, those coins, loose coins were very much in circulation. So she, what she was trying to do, in order to collect 60 paise, as she had earlier calculated that she would be needing 60 paise for her two-way round from her village to the town and then from town to the village. So she started collecting money for that, and from where she got that money, she saved all the stray coins, all the loose coins from her way at home, wherever she found the loose coin kept by her mother or any of her family members in the home, she would start collecting that, or any pocket money which was given by her mother. Okay, so she started saving that, and she was very thrifty. She was a thrifty girl. Yes, one more character trait is coming here, and we can conclude here that she was not spending that money which she was saving for the bus journey. So she was very thriftily means one who spends money in a very careful manner, not elaborate manner. Suppose your parents have given you 500 rupees as a pocket money, and some students, what they do, they spend the entire money in a single go. And some students, they are very smart and they spend that money in a very careful manner, and they just spend 100 or 120 or 150 on their desiring list or the desire thing they want, and rest of the money they save it for next demand to be fulfilled by them, or the next desire to be fulfilled. So here we can see that Wali is not only matured girl, but she is also a very careful girl. She saved stray coins in a very careful manner in order to collect 60 paise for her journey. So how she saved those stray coins? Saved whatever stray coins came her way, resisting every temptation. See, resisting every temptation. That means controlling. She controlled all the temptations, all the appeal, all the urges she had in her heart. You know that, especially if I take your example, that you have number of urges that I want, yes, Adidas shoes, and with that I must have jeans, a branded jeans, okay, and with that a matching shirt should be there of that brand, and then I must have a pair of goggles, Ray-Ban goggles. So these are the various urges which comes into your heart from time to time. Fine. So this here we do see that she was a small child of 8 years. She had number of urges, even just like you or any other child of her age, but she controlled and she resisted every temptation. See, what she controlled, what were the things which she wanted to buy? Temptation to buy peppermint. See, to buy peppermints, toys, balloons, and the like. And the like means similar object. Fine. So she wanted to buy peppermints. The peppermints are the toffees. Toys. Obviously, children love to buy toys. And then balloons, colorful balloons, they are the most favorite thing of children, and the like and similar objects she wanted to buy. And finally, she had saved a total of 60 paise. So she controlled a lot, she suppressed her desires and urges, and finally she didn't spend her money, the stray coins which she was collecting and saving for the bus. She didn't spend a single penny out of that for meeting her desires of peppermints or toys or balloons or any other item. Fine. So finally or eventually she had saved a total of 60 paise. So here we can conclude that finally the financial need or the financial obstacle of that girl Vali was now dealt with. Vali had very smartly and very meticulously she had dealt with this financial problem. How difficult it had been, particularly that day at the village fair. But she had resolutely stifled a strong desire to ride the merry-go-round. See, what she had desire, she had a desire, strong desire to ride the merry-go-round. Children, see, once there was a village fair which was organized in her village. So that day was a very testing day for Vali. Because you know that once children are taken to the village fair, they cannot control themselves. And if it is about various kinds of rides, then they make a number of demands from their parents. Okay, that they want that this ride, that ride, or various other things they demand from their parents. And they are so stubborn and adamant that they do not move ahead. Okay, they don't take a single step ahead until and unless their parents fulfill their demand. So it was really very difficult for a girl of 8-year-old Vali to control her desires. But here what we came to know that she had resolutely stifled a strong desire. Resolutely means with strong determination. She was such a strong-willed girl that she stifled, she controlled, she suppressed a strong desire. And what was that strong desire in the village fair? And that strong desire was that to ride the merry-go-round. Okay, that was the strong desire at a village fair, even though she had the money. Although she had the money, which money here she had? The 60 paise she had saved for the bus journey. So she had the money when she had visited the village fair. But even then, instead of spending that saved money for fulfilling her strong desire to have a ride on the merry-go-round, that young little girl, that precocious child, that mature girl, she felt it better to use that money for only the bus ride. So here we can see that how that girl had controlled over her desire. So she was a really a strong-willed girl. Now let's see next what further development takes place in the story. After she had enough money saved, so now she had sufficient money with her. Her next problem was how to step out of the house without her mother's knowledge, without the knowledge or without the notice of anyone at the house. Now the problem was how to leave the home, how to sneak out of the house without informing her mother. But she managed this. How smart she is. She even managed this problem. She managed the financial problem. And now another problem with her was how to leave the house without informing anyone, without bringing this this journey information into the notice of her mother. So what she did, how she managed, let's see. But she managed this without too much difficulty. Without much difficulty, she didn't have to take much pain for this. And what did she, let us know what she did. Every day after lunch, her mother would nap from about 1 to 4 or so. Vali always used these hours for her excursions as she stood looking from the doorway of her house. So students, how smart that girl was that she knew that her mother daily takes a nap, a short sleep between 1 o'clock till 4 hours. So it was the tentative time period. That's why it is written that 1 to 4 or so. Or so means sometimes it could be 1 to 3:30, sometimes it could be 1 to 4:30, or sometimes it could be 1 to 4. So that was the tentative time period. That was the tentative slot which was used by her mother for taking a rest, for taking a short sleep. So Vali knew clearly that when her mother goes on sleep, she can easily move out of the house, and she used to. Yes, she used to take advantage of this time period. And what she would do? Vali always used these hours. See, Vali always used these hours for her excursions. Excursion means a small trip, a short trip. So she had this habit in her routine that whenever her mother would go to sleep, or she had a short sleep, then she would slip out of her house. She had a short trip to wear. As she stood looking from the doorway of her house, or sometimes even ventured out into the village. So sometimes she would stand at her door, front door, to observe the vehicles going outside or the things happening outside. And sometimes she would use that time to venture out. To venture out means to move out into the village. So she was a wanderer girl, a loitering girl. She would love to move in the streets of a village whenever she would feel like, and what time slot she would choose during the after lunch, when her mother would finish her home chores, she would usually take sleep, a short sleep from 1 to 4 hours. That's why we read previously that why Vali had chosen that particular slot of 1 o'clock. What she had decided, she had planned that when she would start her bus journey at 1 o'clock, because that was the fixed time when her mother went to sleep. So see how intelligent and how witty that girl was. Unlike Bholi, we found her that she was a witless fool. Fine. So she is here. Vali is a rational girl, a logical one. She applies her brain in very smart manner, and she carefully saved the stray coins which whatever came to her way, and now she is all free to go for her bus journey. So these same hours, so she had already she had the habit of going out of her house, but now she wanted to move out. Now she had that confidence, she had built that confidence that she had several times moved out of house into the streets. So now she wanted to move and see the outside world. She wanted to move out from her village. That's why she chose to go on a bus ride. As she would see the bus moving or plying or commuting from her in her street in front of her house. So there it started, that dream, she started dreaming, and that desire started increasing day by day, and over the days that became the strongest desire. And now she was going to fulfill that desire, because she had collected, she had saved the 60 paise by saving. How she saved that money? By resisting her controls and not buying peppermint toys, balloons, and not having a merry-go-round ride at a village fair. Fine. So these same hours could be used for the first excursion outside the village. So the author says that Vali could use these same hours, 1 to 4 or so, that slot could be used for her first excursion, first journey, short journey outside the village. Now the bus is moving into the town. So let's see that how author has described the things while the bus moves on. Vali is inside the bus. The bus rolled on. Rolled on, that means it doesn't mean rolling like this, rolling in a circular manner. Rolled on means moving. The bus moved on, now cutting across a bare landscape. Bare means empty landscape. Landscape is a plain area where trees are not found. So it was a deserted land from where the bus was moving on. Now rushing, that means the bus was in a great speed and it was moving at a very fast speed through a tiny hamlet. Tiny hamlet, tiny means very small. Hamlet means a small settlement, a place where you can see few houses. Okay, so a small village was there through a small place where few settlements, few houses were built. Or past an old wayside shop, and the bus moved through that tiny hamlet, tiny small settlement, and also passed by a shop which was on the side of the way. Sometimes the bus seemed on the point of gobbling up another vehicle that was coming towards them, or a pedestrian crossing the road. So here is one more word, gobbling. Gobbling means eating away, swallowing something in a very fast manner, devouring something, okay, very fastly, quickly. So here the bus was moving in such a high speed, and it entered into passed through a tiny hamlet, and it crossed the shops, and at some moment of time it seemed, actually the author has written everything, given the description from the child's perspective point or perspectives or view of the valley, because she was sitting inside the bus and she was watching all this. So this description is given from valley's point of view. So valley sometimes felt that as if the bus is moving in such a high speed that as if it will gobble up, eat up other vehicles which were moving on the roads that was coming towards them, or a pedestrian. Pedestrian means one who walks on foot, on the footpath, on the side where the vehicles don't run. So at a point of time the bus was moving in such a manner, Valli felt that the bus would gobble up or eat away or swallow those all the vehicles which were there on the way and all the pedestrians who were crossing the road. But lo, somehow it passed on smoothly, but nothing happened like that. So it was a first journey of Valli. It was for the first time she was watching all these things. She hadn't experienced those vehicles, big or large vehicles on the way. So she was sitting inside the bus, and it seemed to her, while sitting on the comfortable and cozy seat, she found that the bus was moving in such a great speed, in such a haste. She felt that all those vehicles which were coming on the way of the bus might gobble up, the bus might swallow up. But nothing such happens. We all know that we travel through bus, we travel through our vehicles. So nothing goes, all the things, they change their directions and move from left and side direction from where they get the way. Leaving all obstacles safely behind. But lo, somehow it passed on. So somehow the all the vehicles and the pedestrians, they passed on smoothly without getting hit by the bus or without getting gobbled by the bus, and leaving all obstacles. So all the obstacles which were coming in front of the bus, they were moving, or they were leaving behind. The bus was moving and everything was going back, moving back. Now trees came running towards them. Now what she found, as if the trees were coming or running towards the bus. When we travel through train, we also see that it seems as if the entire scene outside the train window, it seems that as if it is running or it is coming towards us. But what happens, the moment we reach that place, it moves back, it started going back. So that is what is Valli experiencing here. And she found that the trees were approaching towards them, but then stopped as the bus reached them and simply stood there helpless for a moment by the side of the road before rushing away in the other direction. So what she thought, that those trees which were approaching the bus, the trees were not approaching actually, the bus was moving towards, moving ahead. So Valli thought that those trees were coming or approaching towards the bus, and they would simply stood. When they would reach that position, the trees would stand still, but actually it doesn't happen so. And by the side of the road before rushing away, and the trees, what happened, they rushed away, they moved away in the other direction, and the bus moved ahead. Suddenly Valli clapped her hands with glee. Glee is another word, new term, which means joy or happiness. So she was very excited, and when the children are very happy and excited, what they do, how they express their emotions, they simply clap with their both hands. Okay, that means they enjoy the things and immediately they start clapping with their hands. So now Vali clapped her hand with glee, and what was the reason, what she had seen that made her so glee, so happy, so joyful? So it is about a young cow. So let's see. A young cow, tail high in the air, was running very fast right in the middle of the road. So now another thing which Vali witnessed in her first journey was about a cow. It is about a cow, and that cow was young cow. Young cow means a calf, a baby cow was there, and the most interesting part of that cow was that its tail was upside. It was not downside, it was not hanging downside, but the tail was upside. So it was quite funny for Vali. So that's why Vali laughed, and she started clapping with glee. So it is mentioned that tail high in the air means the tail of that cow, that young cow, that baby cow, was upside in the air, and she was running, the cow was running very fast right in the middle of the road. So in the middle of the road she saw that young cow right in front of the bus. So that young cow, the baby cow, happens to move near what, near that in front of the bus. So right in the middle of the road, right in front of the bus. The bus slowed to a crawl. So in order to save that young cow which had come in front of the bus, the driver applied brake and slowed down the speed of the bus, because earlier we read that the bus was moving in a very high speed. Now the bus slowed to a crawl. Crawl means, have you seen a child? The child crawls, that means moves in very slowly. So the speed of the bus had also slowed down, and it seemed as if the bus was crawling on the road. And the driver sounded his horn loudly again and again. So in order to make that young cow move from the middle of the road, so that the bus could move with great speed again and reach the town at proper time, the driver started honking or creating sound so that the young cow could move from there. So the driver was repeatedly sounding the horn, but the more he honked, he means the driver, the more he blew that horn, the more frightened the animal became, and the faster it galloped away. Galloped means jumped. Out of fear, the young baby cow started jumping, and it couldn't understand what to do. It became so frightened on hearing the loud blowing of the horn by the driver, and the baby cow became fearful and always right in front of the bus. Although the young cow wanted to move from the middle of the road, but the more the driver was honking or blowing the horn, the more the cow felt very difficult to move away from the baby cow became confused. So students, here I can show you the illustration. Here you can see the bus and cow is there, and you can also see the tail which is there upside, okay, in the air. So Vali might be watching this scene from this window. So she found this young cow with its tail up in the air a very funny, and on seeing that cow she started laughing and she enjoyed this scene over here. So students, I hope this is sufficient for you for today's class. We shall continue the chapter in our next video, and hope that this is clear to all of you. So I will come again with a new lecture with explanation in a better way. So till then, take care and bye-bye. I will post the homework questions on your Scholar ERB app.
So students, stay safe, stay healthy. Bye-bye.